It's something that you start doing months prior and you don't realize it, and then all of a sudden your shoulder's bothering you. Even if you've discontinued swimming, which you have, it's still gonna be residual pain. So now is a good time to address it. You will be able to get back to swimming. It's just, we gotta make sure the mechanics of the shoulder are doing better. This is a 5-pound kettlebell. So I'm replacing this with the dumbbell you did last time. So what I'm gonna have you do is hold it right straight overhead. Okay, now you wanna keep your wrist locked, if you can, and the elbow. Okay, now what you're gonna do is draw the shoulder blade down toward the table, and then you're gonna press the arm up toward the ceiling. So again, keep your elbow locked if you can. So you're kinda just punching the arm up and down as a whole unit. Try to keep the elbow straight, beautiful. So right now what we're working on is a little muscle underneath the, kind of at the bottom of the shoulder blade, called the serratus anterior, and it has sort of like a winged out position where it then attaches to your rib cage. This muscle is really important with keeping the inferior angle of the scapula, the little pointy end of the scapula, down. Patients that have this sort of scapulohumeral rhythm deficit tend to have weak serratus anterior muscles, and the scapula sits in sort of a winged out position. When we evaluated Patty, her left shoulder blade was a little bit more winged out than the right side. So this is a nice activity to target that specific muscle. And again, helping to re-engage those very small shoulder blade muscles that are very underused.